So, you want to buy your first home. House prices have started going down in many countries, and that may seem like a good news. But the reality is a bit different, because a decline in prices doesn't necessarily mean that buying a house is more affordable. Let me explain. House prices are driven by a variety of factors, but the key one is the mortgage rate, which reflects the cost of borrowing money to buy a house. And the mortgage rate is largely determined by the policy interest rate set by the central bank. And the driving force behind all of this is inflation. If inflation is more than where the central banks wants it to be, then it may raise the policy rate to make it more expensive for banks to borrow money from it. This will likely push up mortgage rates as banks pass on their higher borrowing costs to home buyers, especially when the interest rate on the mortgage is variable and can change depending on market conditions. Typically, when mortgage rates go up, the demand for houses go down, leading to lower house prices. But it may take time for prices to go down, depending on the availability and demand for housing, which might be sustained due to changes in consumer preferences, for example, toward teleworking. In fact, when interest rates are high and supply is constrained, it may be more affordable to continue renting than to buy a property. And this could keep pressures on rental costs until overall prices adjust. What is important is that the rate of decline for houses isn't more than the economy can absorb, because the housing market is strongly connected to also other parts of the economy. This means that a sharp decline in house prices could have a wider impact on the economy through different channels. First, when housing prices are lower, the wealth of homeowners is reduced. This could lead to lower consumer spending and economic growth. Second, a sharp drop in house prices can affect construction, worsening the economic slowdown. Finally, lower house prices and economic activity could also increase the probability of default on existing loans. This could undermine the stability of financial institutions, making them less willing to extend new loans and further impacting investment and consumption. The impact of lower house prices is then likely to be larger if house prices are overvalued or if households are more indebted when the interest rates change. To mitigate then the risk from a decline in house prices, policymakers should monitor the housing market and take timely and targeted steps to limit the vulnerabilities in the sector. This could include the tools that restrict demand for riskier loans when house prices are rising, or policy measures aimed at ensuring adequate capital of financial institutions. Finally, efforts to boost affordable housing and reduce speculation through improved property taxation are also important steps to mitigate house price pressures and protect against future large price declines.